This place just means the world to me.
And it just was so freeing. Just seeing how far I could go.
I thought, this is the place I need to come.
I'm Justin Dunford, age 34. I had a one-ton piece of sheet metal fall off an overhead crane that bent me in half.
I'm Sam Guillory. I'm 18 years old, and I broke my neck in a car accident.
I'm Curtis. I was in a car accident, which left me with hemiparesis on the left side.
The accident was on April 3rd, 2012. It's my little son's birthday.
The day that I got hurt and then I couldn't see him in 3 days. I couldn't see him until 3 days. Well, I got first he had a black eye.
At my L2, I had a burst fracture. They didn't think that I'd ever walk again from the very beginning, from when I was first told. I don't know how to explain it, but I really wasn't scared because I just felt like I was gonna walk again no matter what they were saying.
Okay, ready? And go, up to 4.0.
The care at Neurworx is absolutely amazing.
There you go, come on, push it. You got it, come on.
They push you to steps that you didn't think you could take. And
good, come on, come on. Yeah, we've been pushing Justin for a while now. Come on.
You go right on with it.
5.0, that's the fastest he's ever run in the pool before.
They seem to find a way to just motivate you. Just him, he's my biggest motivation.
Like right now he can do lots of stuff by himself.
But at first he couldn't, right?
Yeah.
So what did you do to help?
Go.
Oh, your daddy beat you.
I just helped.
So that's Preston, my son Preston Hunter. He's almost 6 years old now. Happy little boy. He comes here to work on the Lokomat.
Yeah, we're getting hooked up into the robot.
He calls it the robot. This is his robot doctor.
Are you ready to go?
Yep.
Okay.
It becomes a game to him.
Got it.
Did you get one?
Yep. And in first place so far.
You're in first place so far?
We're not exactly sure what his condition is. He's been termed a cerebral palsy patient, but he doesn't have all the classic signs and symptoms. He understands that if he works, it's going to make his legs stronger.
You have to really work on your legs.
Yeah, and that makes bigger mountains.
Yep.
He knows. He knows that it's going to strengthen.
Wow, look how far I went.
I've improved a lot with my arms. I can push myself with my own manual chair. I can lift a lot more weight than I did when I started. It feels good to not just be laying around anymore and to kind of go for something. So I don't mind working hard at all. I like them to push me, and that's what they do.
Jacob has, we put him in a category, cerebral palsy, undiagnosed muscle spasticity. They take Jacob to the pool, which is a very special pool. It's heated, the floor rises. So he strengthens his arms, his legs.
Pick this leg up, let's march.
It's an emotional thing for him as well. It's someplace he can go, that he has friends. And he knows these people, he's happy to come. So not only the physical side is being met.
I got your legs, you get your body.
But the emotional as well.
All right, Curtis. I'm gonna loosen leg straps. They're a little tight on the left.
I have been coming here to Neurworx since
April of 2011.
All right, let's do this.
I walked on the Lokomat.
Get over to that right side for me, kick that left leg.
And it's been a big improving step forward, so to speak, in my progress in learning how to walk.
There you go, good job. Good job, Curtis.
I actually rolled in the door with my wheelchair. Now I walk in the door.
Beautiful, now step left.
My goal is to be confident enough to donate my wheelchair one day to someone who needs it, to be at a point where I don't need it anymore. That would be exciting.
Slide over.
My name is Mark Foyer, and I come to Neurworx to learn how to walk again.
I'm Sam Arishta. I am 67 years old. I broke my neck at home in an accidental fall.
She is an author, teacher, and founder of the Ms. Wheelchair Utah pageant.
Hi, I'm Meg Johnson, and I'm 31 years old, and I was paralyzed in 2004, and I am one of Neurworx's first patients.
Jumping on the tops of these boulders, jumping from one boulder.
I was hiking in St. George, and I was jumping on the rocks, jumping from boulder to boulder, and I missed.
And on accident, I just jumped off a cliff. I came home from the hospital 4 months later like this.
When I first started coming to Neurworx in 2004, and I was one of their very first patients, and it was so liberating.
I've kind of turned into that therapist that never says never, because I'm always afraid that person that I said never to will walk or roll through the door and say, you shouldn't have told me never.
She didn't have limitations for me. And she just didn't know how far this was going to go. And learning to do things at the hospital said, oh, she'll never learn that, or she'll never be able to do that. But after coming here, I could do those things.
Three more.
The therapists here have a way different attitude in that they don't seem to have that ceiling of, well, the books say that you're a C7 quad, and so that's all that you can be. Here there doesn't seem to be a ceiling.
We're here at Neurworx for therapy for Marley, trying to keep her muscles going and the strength in her arms.
15, good. Okay, faster. Up.
She's a triplet, and she, Mary is her identical twin, and then there's Faith. She's fraternal. Her sisters are really involved, and again, Matt makes that, and all of them, all the therapists here that we work with, make it really like a family thing. It's great.
Mary.
What's happened over the last 20 years is the length of stays for hospital care has substantially decreased.
And once you get to outpatient, you move to your outpatient benefits on most insurances. And that will get you 20 to 30 visits. And then they think that you should be done.
The insurance runs out and people with spinal cord injuries don't have anything else to do. So they've created this wellness program to where they allow us to come in anytime.
We've got patients that at 30 visits would still be in a wheelchair.
So by giving people more, we have to give them more visits, more time per visit, more intensive therapy, more specialized equipment, and more expertise.
I mean, that's kind of the medical dogma right now, that what you have at about 2 years is what you can expect. And what I realize as a clinician, no one really knows how much someone can progress.
And it's no different than if you went out and wanted to learn a new skill, say tennis, and you did a 15-minute tennis lesson for, 3 weeks. And then you said, okay, that's it. That's all your tennis lessons are going to be. I mean, we'd all look at that and go, well, that's not going to work. So I don't know why we look at these injuries and say, okay, we'll give you 40 minutes of therapy, 5 weeks, and then you're done. Here's your wheelchair, have a nice life.
I drive up from Arizona Monday morning and I stay here during the week. When I got here, I wasn't able to step. I wasn't able to stand. What they're doing is training my legs, training the spinal cord to recognize stepping patterns. Your body recognizes that and it wants to walk.
I know you're tired. Get that left leg straight.
Mark sees hope here. He hears it, he sees it, he discusses it with people, and then he provides that hope for people that are behind him when it comes to the rehab process.
I passed out, fell back, and hit my head on the dresser drawer. And I broke at C5, and I was immediately quadriplegic. I couldn't move my arms, my hands. It was pretty grim that I'd never walk again. Neurworx had helped me to the point that I could walk in here instead of coming in a wheelchair. I just come here and work hard at recovery. Yeah, come on, come on, come on! I tried water skiing and it was really hard. And golfing was the thing that I lost entirely. And that vibration plate machine, I practiced my swing on that.
Some are better, some are worse. They inspire each other, they teach each other. That is an important aspect of this whole thing.
I serve an example like Dale served for me. I've seen him carry a computer in here, that if that man can do it, somebody always serves as that.
I found through research that this was one of the best in the country, and I feel that it is.
Beautiful catch. That was great. Good job.
Neurworx does so much good for so many people, and there are still so many more people who need this so much good that's here.
I can never be thankful enough for what everybody here has done for me.
They have made a huge change in her life, and if they hadn't been here, I don't know where we would be.
If I had to do this over again, now that I know of Neurworx, this is exactly the place I would come back to.
It's been an amazing blessing. You know, it's a tremendous privilege to meet the people that we meet. I mean, these people are extraordinary.